So we're going to start off, how do you know if a shape in a coordinate plane is a parallelogram or not? Well, you could prove that both pairs of opposite sides are congruent. So you could prove that this side, if I was to draw this, so I could prove that both pairs of opposite sides are congruent, so I need to prove that the blue and this blue are the same length, and then also prove that the green are the same length, and I can see visually that they're not. I could prove that both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. To talk about parallel, you look at the slope. If the slope is the same, we say it's parallel. You can prove that both pairs of opposite angles are congruent. There's really not an easy way to do that. You could draw diagonals. You could draw a diagonal from here to here. And then from here to here. And then talk about the midpoint. And then see, do the diagonals cut each other in half? You could do it that way. It's just not a very easy way. Or you could prove that one pair of opposite sides are both congruent and parallel. And so the way I think is probably the easiest way, just based off experience, the one I'm going to do is number two. So I think number two, so you have five different ways you could prove a parallelogram. Number two is definitely the easiest way. So instead of spending a day going and showing you how do you do number one, how do you prove using number two, how do you prove using number three, number four, number five, I'm just going to focus in on the easiest way and go from there. So we're going to prove that both pairs of opposite sides are parallel, and if they are, then we would say it's a parallelogram. Now how do we do that? We do that with the slope. So let's say you have a parallelogram, maybe a parallelogram, and we call it Joy's. So you got J, that's at 1, 1. We have J at 1, 1. We have O at 2, negative 6, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have Y at 3, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. We have S at 2, 10. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we're asked to prove if this is a parallelogram. So by the question is basically telling us that yes, it is a parallelogram. But we're supposed to prove it. And so I have from here to here. And then on the other side, so the easiest way is to prove that the green line segment and this green line segment have the same slope. And then prove that the pink line segment and this pink line segment have the same slope. So now the question is, how do you find slope? So to find the slope from here to here, first of all, this is going up, so this slope's positive. We do what's called rise over run. So if I start at this point, I rise how many? And I run how many? And that's our slope. Well, from here, I go up one, up two, up three, up four, up five, up six, up seven, up eight, up nine. So this is up nine. And I go over one. And then I really should put the points on there. So let's see, this is J right here. O is at 2, negative 6. O is down here. Y is right there. And S up here. So I can say the slope of JS is rise over run, which would be 9 over 1. We're going to compare that to the slope of not JS but OY. So from here, I go up how far, and I go over how far. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, up 9 over 1.
I thought you were saying.
So the slope of OY is also 9 over 1, which I forgot to reduce. 9 divided by 1 is 9. 9 divided by 1 is 9. So I just proved that JS and OY are parallel. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this part just to make it easier to see. So the green is good. The green is parallel. But I also have to prove that both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. So now I need to prove that the pink is parallel to the pink. So now let's go look at that. So if I start here, rise, I go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left 1. So I would say the slope of JO is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then because I went to the left one, anytime we go to the left, it's negative. And 7 divided by negative 1, negative 7. I would then check the slope here. So how far up do I go? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left 1. So the slope of YS is also up 7, left 1, which equals negative 7. So because my final statement, since JS, since the slope of JS equals OY equals 9, and slope of JO equals YS equals negative 7, this shape is a parallelogram. All right, next, let's say you know where three of the points are in a parallelogram. Where would you put the fourth point to make a parallelogram? Well, let's see, one's at negative 1, 2. Negative 1, 2. Another point's at 4, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And another point at 6, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I almost have a parallelogram. It looks like a triangle right now. But it's not a triangle. The other point's going to be down here somewhere. So we're going to make a point, like obviously from here to here, that's not a parallelogram. So how do we know where to put the fourth point? We know where these three are. Well, we're going to use slope. And so if I count from here to here, that'll tell me what I need to do over here. And so looking right here, if I do the slope, I'm going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then left 2. So really this is just 2 to the right and then 6 down. So if I do the same thing from this point and just go 2 to the right and then 6 down, that tells me exactly where I should put my point. So it should go here. And then I could also confirm the slope on the other one. From here to here, I'd go up 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it should be the same. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So yes, this is where I would put my next point. So now I can make the rest of my parallelogram. From here to here. And from here to here. And so find the point. Well, this point's at 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I would say the other point would be at 1, negative 4.